Hello and welcome to video 4 of 9 for chapter 1. This video I'm going to be talking about roughly sections 122 and 123 of the textbook. Topic is translating conjunction and negation operators. So if we take the following two atomic statements, roses are red, violets are blue, there's a lot of ways in English that these could be expressed as a conjunction. So we can just use and. Roses are red and violets are blue. Sometimes we can say both X and Y. So both roses are red and violets are blue. We can, but is also a conjunction. I'll talk more about this in chapter 2. You might think, oh, but seems different from and. And it is, but the difference isn't a logical difference. There's a kind of psychological difference, but logically they're the same. It's still saying both of these parts are true. Both of the atomic statements are true. Now, if we assign a capital letter R and V to the two atomic statements, and you're going to be doing a lot of this as we do these translations, the first step is going to be to identify the atomic statements and assign a capital letter to each one. Once we've done that, we can rewrite these conjunctions in this way. They're all saying R and V, and we're going to use the dot as our symbol for conjunction. Now, there's other symbols that people sometimes use for conjunction. Don't worry about that. Don't get emotionally attached to your symbols. We're going to use a dot in this course. Now, it's going to be convenient for us sometimes when we have a conjunction like R and V to be able to talk about the components of that conjunction. So we will just call them conjuncts. So R and V is a conjunction. The first conjunct is R. The second conjunct is V. So conjunction, pretty straightforward. Next up is negation. Negation also can be expressed in natural language like English in a lot of ways. So if we take an atomic statement like the cat is on the mat, there's a lot of ways I could negate that I could express the logical function of negation in English. I could say the cat is not on the mat. The cat isn't on the mat. It's false that the cat is on the mat. It's not true that the cat is on the mat. There's a bunch of ways to do that. If I assign the capital letter C to that atomic statement, the cat is on the mat, then all of these negated versions of that atomic statement we could write as tilde C. So the tilde is the symbol we're going to use for negation. And again, sometimes people use different symbols. Don't worry about that. In this course, we're going to use a tilde. Again, don't get emotionally attached to specific symbols. Okay, with these two operators down, let's do some examples. So here's an example. It's pretty straightforward. I am not thirsty. Step one when translating something into formal notation is to identify the atomic statement. Now, the atomic statement is going to be whatever isn't conjoined with another operator or isn't negated. Here it is negated. There's a negation here. So the atomic statement is the non-negated version. So the atomic statement is going to be I am thirsty. And let's call that T, T for thirsty. Once I've identified the atomic statement and assigned a letter to it, I'm going to rewrite my original sentence, but I'm just going to plug the capital letter back in for the atomic statement. Now, it's a little bit, don't worry about this, this is very intuitive. The not kind of shows up in the middle of this. We can't put the not like in the middle of the letter T, so I'm just going to put not T, but it's pretty clear that's still like the negation of T, the negation of this atomic statement. Now we just have to turn the word here, not, into the symbol, which is going to be the tilde. So we would translate I am not thirsty just as tilde T. What about this one? What about I am thirsty and I am hungry? So again, the first thing we're going to want to do is to identify the atomic statements involved in that compound statement. And there's two. Okay, nothing's negated, but there's two atomic statements. I'm hungry, call that T. I'm thirsty, call that T. I am hungry, call that H. Okay, now I'm going to rewrite the original statement, plug those two back in, and I will get T and H. And then finally, I'm going to finish up by translating the and just in terms of our dot. So we get T dot H. Okay, that was a short one. That was just how to translate conjunction and negation.